They know that this is just the start. Our state and our country have not yet reached the peak in coronavirus cases, but already hospital beds here are filling up and supplies are running out.
We are not able to take care of you if we get sick ourselves.
Nurses across the valley are sounding the alarm.
We're seeing our beds filling up. We're seeing units filling up with persons under investigation, as well as people that are positive.
In total, Nevada has 5,000 hospital beds. 700 of those are in ICUs.
We are being proactive in trying to get people out of the hospital that don't need to be here.
And already 80% are full.
Stay home because we have people that are on ventilators.
Stay home to stop the spread, and unless it's an emergency, stay home to spare our healthcare system.
This is not just one hospital. It's across Las Vegas, it's across Nevada, it's across our country.
Valley nurses are calling on President Trump and the federal government to enforce the Defense Production Act. The measure would direct private companies to ramp up production of critical goods during a national emergency.
We need companies manufacturing the equipment and supplies that we need yesterday.
In this case, nurses want more and they need more N95 masks, gloves, and other personal protective equipment, also known as PPE.
Our numbers are multiplying, so we need them now.
We've seen it in China first, now Italy, and all over the United States. If health care workers, including doctors, nurses, respiratory therapists, and anybody that's providing care to these patients aren't protecting themselves, then they're getting ill, they're getting sick, and they are dying.
Las Vegas nurses also want better guidance. They say hospitals are trying to stretch their supplies, but at what cost?
And if hospitals have the equipment, we need to use it. They don't need to save it for a rainy day. This is the rainy day.
If we don't conserve our nurses, who will be left to wear those N95s? At any point in time, we have been told we can wear them, we're not allowed to wear them, they take them away, they give them back.
These nurses are dedicated to saving lives, but they say they can't do so if they can't stay healthy.
I have a family. I have a family I want to go home to as well.
And I want to see us have a tomorrow. And I know that unless we do something to change what is happening, many people will not see a tomorrow.
And nurses told me they've also heard of the community stepping up to sew masks. While they say it's very thoughtful, they don't believe it'll be enough to protect them.